Hello, Internet. I'm Matt Gutt from TheHouse.com, and this is a 2019 LibTech Titty Fish Snowboard. It's designed by Jamie Lynn. It's for all mountain freestyle use for intermediate to advanced level riders that have size 11 feet and larger. This is a deck with a little bit wider of a platform that helps people with bigger feet not catch their toes and their heels when they're cruising around. This is a little bit more of an aggressive deck than you'll find in most of the LibTech line. It has precision, control, and of course a lot of power because of the C3 profile shape. But as you see, it's a directional style shaped board. The nose is quite a bit longer than the tail. The tail has a 10 millimeter taper, and the stance is set back 1.5 inches. But with all that being said, it does have the side cut radius and the profile shape centered within the feet. Now that C3 profile shape, it's gonna feel like a classic kind of camber board. As you see, it kind of arcs up, but there is a raised rocker section between the feet that make it a little bit more pliable than most full camber boards. But I'm really glad that LibTech is kind of exploring back into camber decks. They have a lot of energy, they're really quick edge to edge, and they have the ollie spot where you want them most, right in the tail. The Titty Fish has a feel and flex rating of about a 6, a little bit stiffer than your average board, and that's because of original power construction. There's 75% Aspen style wood and about 25% in Polonia. The Polonia strips actually run in between the insert packs and the rails down both sides of the board, and that's been wrapped in a triax glass on top, which gives it a little bit more of a lively feel, and a biax glass on bottom. But overall, though, the thing is a resort ripper. You know, you can ride it this way, or most people actually who ride it tend to ride it, you know, nose pointed downhill, but you can still ride it this way. But, you know, because that tail has a 10 millimeter style taper, because the nose is 1 centimeter wider, it's going to ride quite a bit better in deep snow than a lot of other all-mountain twin freestyle boards. It's going to sink the tail when you're in deep snow and keep the nose afloat, which is actually a really good thing, of course. Now, the boards are built tough in America, and that's why they have an ultra-high molecular weighted sidewall and an internal birch-style sidewall, too. You know, they put a lot of care in the construction, and that's why they do so well with so many people here in the States, and they really last a long time. They focus on, of course, staying fast and having really rad graphics. Jimmy Lynn did all the graphics. But this is the TNT base. I'm surprised they didn't put the sintered base in. TNT is kind of a combination between sintered and extruded from what LibTech says. It absorbs wax more than an extruded base. It's quite a bit faster than an extruded base, but you need to kind of keep your eye on it throughout the season. And then there's that Madden Attraction style edge. This is 7 serrations down this edge. Smaller ones on the nose and on the tail, and larger ones as you get towards the center of the board that really grip on firm snow. The Titty Fish is a fun board, especially for anyone with size 11 feet and larger. You know, if you're all mountain ripper and kind of just like cruising and keeping your board on the ground, this is a really fun deck that's stable at high speeds and, of course, has a really cool name and a really awesome graphic. Make sure to check it out at thehouse.com by selecting the link below in the description. Feel free to leave a comment or a question. Let me know what you think of this thing here. Subscribe to the channel there, check out more vids there, and hopefully I'll see you guys on snow. Peace.